Joining us now, Dr. Robert Murphy is a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning.
Good morning.
We are moving in the wrong direction. The biggest news yesterday, I think, going around was the mask mandate back in California and LA County. Do you think that's coming here?
It's coming here. It's just all a matter of time. Basically, the honeymoon is over. Things really got well. The CDC relaxed its guidelines, and then people didn't follow the guidelines. The guidelines were very clear. If you're vaccinated, you don't have to wear the mask or socially distance. And what happened is the unvaccinated people said, oh, great, we'll just act like the vaccinated people. And that is what's driving the pandemic now, this relaxation of the rules with over half the population unvaccinated. You look, 50% increase in cases in the 38 of our states, 10% overall. LA County, the biggest county in the country, 10 million people, have mandated masks now, in all indoor spaces for everybody, vaccinated, not vaccinated. There's no more difference anymore. They're going backwards. Schools, the whole California system, public system. This is the university system, mask mandates. Rhode Island, same thing. It's, here, many of the schools in Chicago, same thing. It's all coming.
So, Dr. Murphy, do you think it's a bad idea to close these big vaccination centers?
Well, the big vaccination centers, Anna, is there's nobody going to
right.
them. So they got these big, all these resources are in these giant places where there's hardly anybody walking in. The problem is getting the people to take the vaccine. So the focus is to close those big places, take that money and put it into the local places where people are not vaccinated. In Cook County, we've got in suburban Cook County, 60% of the people are vaccinated. But in South Cook County, it's 45%. In the north, it's 68%. So, they got to shift some of the resources down to where the people are not taking the vaccines for whatever reason. Figure it out and let's try to get the people vaccinated and safe.
All right, let's get to a couple of questions here, starting with this one. The lack of news about the Johnson & Johnson vaccine has me worried. Is there any harm to go ahead and get one shot of Pfizer or Moderna to act as a booster shot?
Yeah, Dan, I'm glad you brought this up because this is one of the more common questions that I'm getting like every day. So there is some good news about the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. Actually, last week, they reported that the immunity in a complicated way that they measure it was very strong 8 months after that single dose was given. So they're not claiming like, Pfizer said, oh, the antibodies go down, we should have a third dose, which the CDC and NIH didn't buy, by the way. So they've actually had shown some good results with that immunity. So that's great. There's also a study of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine looking at two doses of their vaccine. And that is close to the end. So we'll hear from that. So at this point, if you've had one J&J vaccine, you're safe. There is no third dose approved yet. So, that's going to change, but you'll hear about it soon.
Okay, here's our next question. My fiance and I both caught COVID at the end of December and recovered relatively well. We received our second dose of the Moderna vaccine mid-April. Does having both natural plus boosted immunity provide us any additional immunity to the Delta variant?
Well, this is actually a pretty common situation. It happened to myself, by the way. Yes, they will have a bigger immune response that affects all the variants. So it's not just Delta, but the immune response in people who had COVID and then the vaccine is stronger than either the vaccine alone, which is actually not very good, and the Moderna and Pfizer and even the J&J vaccine. So you put the two together, it's like having like a triple dose.
Gotcha. All right, Dr. Murphy, thanks so much for your time this morning.
Great. Have a good weekend.
You too. If you didn't get your question answered, Dr. Murphy answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit a question via email or head to our WGN Morning News Facebook page, post it there. We'll talk to him again on Monday.